What's up, folks? This is CineLab, and let's get started. So we got a couple more games of the killer for this episode. This build is what I used in the first match. We have our Unrelenting that has the cooldown between our missed basic attacks. Got a Bitter Murmur, which each time a generator is fully repaired, survivors within 16 meters are revealed for 5 seconds, and when the last generator is fully repaired, all survivors are revealed for 10 seconds. That's pretty cool. And of course we've got our Hex Huntress Lullaby. And this one, Spies from the Shadows. So 100% of the time, calling crows, give you a visual cue when I am within 36 meters range, so I can help, you know, when survivors disturb them while running, give me a visual cue where they are, I can help track them. So these are the four that I use in the first game, and I think the second game I swapped out Bitter Murmur for Beast of Prey, which grants me the undetectable after gaining Bloodlust. Yeah, I went back to this one, I guess. But anyway, there's a new UI. They actually did an update. So let me go over those changes. So as where before they had everything down here in the lower left-hand corner, right now, at least for the killer, we just have their main weapon or their main power with their add-ons down here. And the generators that need to be repaired is now here at the top. And the players are all along the side here. And they actually use their character models instead of just the outlines. Their names a little bit more visual. You can see who's hit actually. You can recognize them in-game and make a match here. And then this little guy, at least for the killer, is how many hooks you've got. Each one of these little segments will light up indicating how many successful hooks. But that actually kind of comes in handy with some perks like... the Huntress one, where every time I get someone hooked, the Huntress Lullaby, they get a degradation on how many hooks on their skill checks for, you know, repairing or healing or whatnot. So I think it's a little cool. Still, we got the perks over here, and that's fine. That didn't change. But yeah, not everything's all bunched up in this lower corner now. I like it kind of spread out here. We get a little larger UI, but anyway. Let's get into it. There's people. Busy. Thank you. hell's a hook?
Hey!
Between these two, oh, someone's cleansing a totem. I don't think I have any more hex totems. Or hex perks. I think I got swapped those two out. Oh, this thing is completely non-functional. Nice. Then one gem. What the hell is that noise? Oh, that's the crow. Or the whatever. Munching on something. Now that someone's died there. Well, that sounds like it's really starting to run. near him. Who the hell is he? That's his last time. Let's get back up here to damage this gem. Oh, now the last. Oh, looks like he found the hatch. All right, well that's fine. He did escape. All right. Very good. Someone's over here, and I'm following the blood. Now they're sprinting, I can see the scratch marks. Oh. Didn't know I could just grab them when they're going through a window. Well, that's funny. There's no fucking hooks up here. It's just her up there. I think all the gems are down here. There's shit going on down here. Someone's over here. Nope, that one's already running. Okay. I don't really think I want to be up here, though. I don't think there's any gens up here. train in, and I don't know where this last person is. This one is not doing nothing. Two people dead. I can see my text. Oh, I see a, as a survivor, but as a killer, not so bad. Of course, I did swap out that one perk for the crows. Crows light up and let me know when someone's disturbed them, and that helped.